With the right gear, social media scraping isn't rocket science. Today, I'll go through tool options for a perfect scraping formula. So let's jump in. There are a few tool choices for your web scraping ventures. Spoiler alert, some are more effective than others. And if you're just getting into scraping, stick to beginner options. And only when you grasp the process, shift to the alternatives. You know how they say, slow but steady wins the race? Same thing here. For those starting out, I recommend no-code scrapers. Ready-made scrapers don't need any code and are pretty intuitive for first-time users. Another perk is clear and extensive documentation on how to use the software. Efficiency is also guaranteed. Tools like OctoParse support proxy integration, infinite scrolling, and other valuable features. Some code-free software like ParseHub or already mentioned OctoParse is designed for JavaScript-rendered platforms, including Instagram. Though for advanced scraping, no-code tools might be too primitive. The main drawback is that you can rarely accommodate specific needs like unlimited concurrency. And of course, you can't maintain or fix the scraper if, let's say, it crashes. Tools efficiency often increases when you purchase more expensive plans. So basically, you get what you pay for. Cost-wise, no-code scraping tools reside on the pricey side. So naturally, you might be tempted to go for cheaper options, but I suggest resisting that temptation as unreliable providers offer fewer features and lower quality service. If you look for more control over scraping processes, try advanced techniques. An application programming interface, or in short, API, is a great pick. Some social media platforms like Reddit, Twitter, or Pinterest offer official scraping APIs. And that's a huge plus because it allows you to scrape publicly available data without worrying about legality. Yet some platforms don't see a point in providing an official API, or like Instagram, have taken it down, only narrowing your options. In this case, unofficial scraping APIs can be very useful. Unofficial APIs are created and maintained by the community or external companies, and some are accessible free of charge, though several unauthorized tools run without social networks' consent. So be careful when picking an API. Read its documentation, user reviews, and avoid unofficial APIs with questionable reputation. No matter if you go with official or community-built APIs, both have flaws, like strict rate limits. It means that the platform caps the number of elements you can scrape. For example, the official Twitter API allows you to retrieve up to 900 tweets over a 15-minute window. So if you need to extract large quantities of data in one session, it is out of the question. What's more, official APIs require you to have an authorized account and apply for scraping permissions. Sometimes it takes a while to process a request. So for timely matters, it's a stumbling stone. If you have some coding knowledge, why not build your own scraper and gain some more freedom? One way to do it is to use web scraping libraries or frameworks. You'll find plenty on GitHub, but always read the documentation first. It will let you fully understand the tool's features, use cases, and limits. Python-based web scraping frameworks like Selenium or Scrapy can handle well-protected platforms. You can also use libraries like Beautiful Soup, Cheerio, or Puppeteer. While frameworks can take complex automation easily, libraries are made for a specific function. So for compound tasks, you'll have to play around with several libraries, at least from our experience. Recently, we managed to scrape Twitter with a pre-made SN scrape library, and it worked just fine for basic requests like scraping tweets by search results. I'm pretty sure with some tweaks, the library could handle complex projects. Well, the main advantage in developing a tool is its full customization. And the more you're skilled in coding, the more complex web scraping tools you'll build. So take that as a goal or a challenge. Remember that social media platforms are serious about safety. So whichever tool you pick, you'll have to deal with strict IP monitoring and browser fingerprinting measures. For maximum efficiency, don't forget to integrate rotating proxies and a headless browser. Proxies mediate between you and the internet, change your IP address, and will shield you from IP bans. Meanwhile, headless browsers spoof digital fingerprints and increase scraping success rates. Remember this powerful combo and you're good to go. But if you're looking for more practical tips about social media scraping, check out our data extraction tutorials. In these videos, we show you how to scrape posts, likes, comments, and other content from the most popular platforms like Instagram or Twitter. I'll see you there.